Welcome back.
Thank you. Thanks for having me back. After the last summer, I'm surprised, but here we are.
Well, we've got a bone to pick with you. Yes. Because last time you came on and you told us that you were the new ambassador for South African tourism, which is, yes, you know, logical because you're South African.
Yes.
You're back.
Yes.
You're the tourism ambassador for another place now, yes, which is...
Norfolk Island. Thank you so much for bringing that up, Hamish.
Now, why?
Well, I mean, I did my job as a South African tourism ambassador and they said, well, good job, it's done. You know, everyone's going. And then... Because that's how that works, isn't it? Like, I did it and they're going. And then I was going to Norfolk Island on holiday and they go, oh, you coming over here, this is quite cool, you should be our ambassador. And I went, all right. Because it's such a cool little place and I think a lot of people don't understand where it is, number one, and it's sort of between Australia and New Zealand. It's like our baby. Like Australia and New Zealand had a little baby and it's just there in the middle.
I love the way you go from a South African to a Kiwi accent and back again.
Yeah, no, it's almost like you're drunk, but it affects my voice. It really depends on the amount of booze you
it's
put
really
in it.
It's really easy to pick, though. I mean, you do both really
well. Yeah, it's
well.
A full hybrid.
Yeah.
I'm basically the Prius of an immigrant.
I saw a pic of you at Norfolk Island, a pic, something I've always wanted to be able to do, and you just absolutely nailed it. It's you in the water doing that. I mean, I do you understand, though, you're not meant to show the befores on Instagram? Like, you've just put all of them out there, all the pre photos of
the product. Because I'm all about empowering people, and I think everyone needs to do the hair flick, but they also need to understand you're potentially going to probably drown because there's so much water when you do the flick, you know, because you have to wait underwater for the photographer and then you flick up, but in that time just litres of water runs in your nostrils.
Let's talk about your comedy touring. You got a new show coming up. And last year at the Melbourne International Comedy Festival, you had an outstanding festival. You won the People's Choice Award. I think you sold out like 36 shows. Was there one show that stood out more than anyone else?
Yeah, not at the, I mean, Melbourne was great, but then as soon as I went back home, I tried a new show, you know, new material. As you well know, you have to run stuff in. And I was in this little pub, there's only 80 people in it, and the guy right in front of me on the set, he just fell right through his chair and he got stuck in it. And it's the biggest laugh I've ever got. And it took the entire audience about 6 minutes to get him out of the seat because we were laughing so much we had to push him over and then pull the seat off him. It was the best thing that has ever happened to me.
I'm always intrigued about how comedians come up with names for their shows.
Yeah.
Yours is called Token African. Is it?
Yes.
You're the Token African, presumably.
Yeah, because everyone's got one of us. If you can point out one Australian that has never either met a South African, lived with one, you know, worked with one, or their sister's marrying one.
I spent time in Africa. It was in the jungle for...
Yeah. Oh, you're in a jungle, were you? You're in a jungle. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, I saw little flashes of that.
Yeah, thanks.
Having grown up in South Africa, you live in New Zealand, you spend a lot of time here. Do you notice a big difference in, like, the comedy in each place and how they approach...
No, you know what? I think it's the same everywhere. I think everyone just wants to have a beer and a laugh with their friends and, you know, we all like food and having a chuckle at ourselves, you know, maybe with the exception of Russia and Germany. But the rest of us are very similar, you know, like in what we like is comedy. As people, we're different. Like South Africans, I think we have a different approach. Like, you know, we have that thing that if someone's older, we want to call you auntie or uncle, like you'd be Uncle Steve, you know, like, yeah, like, no, but, you know, we do that and we look after our elderly, which they don't do here. But, but that's like the only difference is I think comedy-wise, we're sort of all on the same page.
Speaking of being on the same page, we're both on Have You Been Paying Attention tonight. We had a ball doing this. This is recorded last night.
Yeah.
But the bachelorette couple, Angie and Carlin, are on tonight.
They were just right.
Oh,
else,
my God.
Honestly.
You were quite smitten with Carlin, though.
Yeah.
A little bit off-brand for you.
Yeah, no, well, I didn't know. It was like, I was like, oh, she is quite attractive. Like, she's a hairier woman, you know. Like, but, you know, who hasn't missed a few waxes or a few three? I'm like, yeah, I mean, you know, she's still attractive. And it was only when the bachelorette went, I'm with him. I'm like, with Tom? And then she pointed to the Portuguese gal, and I was like, oh, that's a dude.
It is. They cop a fair hiding tonight. So, yeah,
it's worth watching. I'd like to watch The Bachelorette with you.
You're welcome, sir.
All right, Ursula's new show, Token African, will be touring Australia next year. Tickets are on sale right now. All the details are on our website. She always makes us laugh. Would you please thank Urzila Carlson?